People think about phobias and they tend to think more so about fear. It's more than that. So we're trying to understand the extremes of fear. We know that there's some very basic structures in your brain that are involved in these kinds of emotions like fear. One of them is called the amygdala. It's kind of like an immediate processor. It's looking for threat. It's looking for what's going on in the world around me and how should I respond. I see something that might be scary. I'm looking for threat. How is my brain then going to interpret that and either upregulate this? I need to, you know, fight or flight, or downregulate. Okay, it's just a scary movie. It's a safe experience. This is going to be fun. So if you think maybe it's gone beyond fear into the realm of phobia, how would you know? Well, if it's starting to get in the way of what you want to do with your life, it can be something as simple as you're afraid of bees and wasps, and I just don't go outside that time of the year anymore. The degree to which you can change your life to avoid the things associated with your fear just becomes more interfering and more problematic than confronting the fear itself. That's usually when a lot of people decide they're ready to see if they can get help. Up to that point, if someone has fears and they feel they're kind of on the cusp, we would recommend, okay, safely, in small doses, try doing what it is you're afraid of. Don't leave it at the point of, I'm terrified, I'm scared, so I'm going to run away, I'm going to avoid this. We know that usually will increase the fear and make it more likely it'll become a phobia. You have an experience with a dog and it barks at you or snarls at you, but maybe it's being playful, not an aggressive dog. If you leave it at that, maybe you have a bad impression of what dogs are like, as opposed to you realize it's a safe dog to be around, and you take the opportunity to settle down, come back at it, and try interacting with the dog again. You're giving yourself corrective information, a new experience to kind of compete with, should I be afraid, or is this fun? Or something in between. If someone is having problems with something more than fear, if it is a phobia, there are individuals out there to help, and there's lots of wonderful resources available.